Oh. I guess there's no use in waiting. I should just break the news. Did you get inside the boat? Have you seen Mada? I'm afraid to inform you that your father was lost at sea. What? That's impossible. He's the captain, and a captain never abandons his ship. Who told you that he was lost? Was it that slimy first mate, the fish? As a matter of fact, it was. Why? Of course. That explains why everyone is collecting seashells. He's trying to find the conch. Ah, he's swindling everyone in town, so they'll help him find a conch shell? It's not just any conch. My da used to tell a story to all those who'd listen. One night, during a terrible storm, a handsome young sailor fell overboard. As he sank down into the sea, a beautiful mermaid came to his rescue. She brought him back to the shore beneath a lighthouse. It was love at first sight, but alas, they couldn't be together. She had fins, and he had feet. But they made a special promise. Whenever he missed her sweet voice, he'd stand under the lighthouse and blow an enchanted conch. No matter where she was, she'd hear the sound and come to see him. That way, they could be together, even if only for a moment. Isn't that romantic? It's just a silly fairy tale, girl. But that gross fish believes it. I bet he thinks he can make the mermaid fall in love with him if he gets that conch. They both get fins. Both got fins, after all. And maybe my da's still out there. Maybe he got rescued by a mermaid, just like in the story. Oh, please. You have to find the conch before the fish does. It might be the only way to find my da. If the fish has everyone in town combing the beach for this thing, what makes you think I'll have a better chance? Maybe they're all looking in the wrong place. The sailor in the story lived in a lighthouse, not on the beach. Lived in a lighthouse. Didn't I see a lighthouse somewhere around here? I think I did. But where? Ah, my blasted memory. I can't seem to remember where I saw it. Oh, but I found a chest with a skipper scale and another crab claw and some more seashells. I'll gladly take all of those. Aha! This is where I saw it, passing by many times on my way back to the marketplace. Lighthouse door, sealed up tight with salt crusted of ages. This old lighthouse has been seen better days, although it towers high above the pier. Paint has faded, and the windows have crusted over with layers of salt. The door refuses to budge. Growths of barnacles and coral seem to have salted it shut. You put your ear to the keyhole and hear the unmistakable roar of the ocean inside. With your face close to the door, you spot words carved into the weathered wood, lengthy, babbling prose about love, loss, and the sea. Bah, What a terrible poetry. But mayhaps it's some forlorn magic left here by the old lighthouse keeper? Well, I don't have the time to go fishing for long-lost keys. A good dose of love juice ought to open up an embittered heart. Love potion. What's this? Oceanic oil? Okay, I'm gonna need oceanic oil. Oh, and I need a dryad fruit, of course. And the oceanic oil, barnacles, some algae, and a deep one. So this is where I need to make the tidal tincture. Oh, lots of things to make. See, I'm gonna need one of these. Word water for the tidal tincture. And one of the runes. But I need, it's not perfect potion, right? Yes. Okay, good thing I have another water. I'm gonna need to collect some more water soon. Okay, so I make a soothing rune. And now I can make a tidal tincture. Okay. I need to try this on one of the deep ones. Ah, there it is. Thought I saw one around here moments ago. There we go. I only needed one, right? Search for this? Yes, okay. Oh. I need more barnacles. Easy enough to get. Like, don't get stuck on these rocks. I just need to find some barnacles around here. Should be enough. We have some oceanic oil. And finally, the dryad potion. Or the dryad fruit to make the love potion. So I've got the oceanic oil. It's a painstakingly collected from the minuscule quantity of secreted away across ocean life. Yeah, sure. Makes sense. And then the love potion, little more than a brain to encourage fondness. Oh, balm to encourage fondness. But often that's all it takes. Okay. Well, let's head back to the forest. Going to need a cinder box. I'll have this done in no time. Okay, headed back to the forest, which is here. Okay, there's a dryad up here, I think. Yes. I'm terribly sorry, but I do need this dryad heart. Thank you very kindly. So sorry. Okay, and one love potion. Done. Okay, back up to the lighthouse. And I suppose I just smear this love potion on the inscription on the door, perhaps? Let me take a good look at that lock. Did I not craft a potion? Oh, I need a key. Oh, I'm... I'm also making a key. Thought it was just the potion. Ah, so it's the potion plus a key to make a love potion key. Got it. Of course, that makes sense. Now that I think about it. Key to my heart. Whatever the nature of desire may be, this is the instrument of unlocking. Okay. Alright, here we go. The rusty lock makes a sound like a sloppy kiss as you turn the key inside it. Bubbling and creaking, the aged metal hinges protest as years of grime dissolves away. The wooden door swings open to reveal a wall of emerald seawater. You can see fish swimming about inside, but not a drop crosses the threshold. Oh my, the entire lighthouse must be filled up like a bottle. You prod the salty aperture with your finger, sending ripples along the surface. Then, as if you pulled a stopper from a tub, the water begins to drain. Slowly at first, but quickly building ferocious speed, the waves cascade around you. You catch notes of trumpeting sound droning above the crashing swells. The music turns to a soft whisper as the last of the flood is sucked away, leaving the inside of the lighthouse damp and encrusted with stranded sea life. You bend down to examine the source of the drainage. A golden conch shell is wedged between the waterlogged floorboards. A forlorn singing voice can barely be heard over the sound of the falling waves. I'll take that. You put the conch to your ear. It sounds as if an entire ocean is contained within it. Ah, what a marvel. I wonder if the mermaid will still answer its call after all this time. The child's story is said to blow it out of the water, over the water, under the lighthouse. Standing at the end of the pier, you blow into the conch. You feel a warm breeze pass through the salty waves and uplift your spirits. A crystal clear trumpeting note rings out from the shell and seems to still the ocean waters to a mirror shine. Sweet laughter chimes like a bell in response, and a shadowy shape approaches from the depths below. An enormous, full-body figure breaches the stillness of the water, throwing her hair back joyfully and extending her arms out to the sun. Oh, she's so gorgeous. She thrusts her body up onto the outcropping of rocks, splashing her long finned tail in the waves. Aha! Speak to the mermaid. Don't mind if I do. As the mermaid speaks, her voice is operatic. Oh, how do I do an operatic voice? I'll just do my best. My gift, lain silent for years. Now sounds again sad music for my ears. My lover long gone, but their memory still sweet. I thank you for the nostalgia. What would you entreat? I'm looking for a man, lost at sea. He was the captain of that tall ship over there. You point to the high sails looming over the docks. I don't suppose you've had any dealings with him? This man I have seen, though his fate is not known, placed on a plank overboard he was thrown. Downward he plunged, through not to the bottom. No, a great serpent swam up from the deep and got him. Ah. So he was pushed overboard, you say? The grubby fish told me he was lost in a storm. Did you see where this leviathan got to? The lagoon by the shore holds a secret below. Send away the tides and the serpent will show. Keep that conch close, blow, and I shall abide. I'll bring the strength of the sea to your side. With her song finished, she blows you a wet kiss and starts preening her hair with a spiny seashell. Oh, she's so cute. Visit the lagoon near the docks. I think that's where the boat was at. Maybe. The one that brought us to that, oh dear, to the island. Here. Hold on, is this the right place? Let me just consult my notes. No more than a short row from the south of the docks. This goes to the lagoon. Yes, lagoon dinghy, of course.